I'm gonna make an assumption. Chances are, if you came across this video, you've probably watched at least a handful of DaVinci Resolve color grading videos. Am I right? Me too. And one thing that I've noticed with a lot of those videos is because they're often focusing on a single idea or concept, they also often only take you through the process of grading one or two different shots. And don't get me wrong, I have videos like that too, because sometimes that's just the best way to get the information across. But in reality, we're almost always grading a whole pile of clips in an entire sequence, scene, short film, whatever it may be, and it's not usually just one shot. So in this video, I'm going to give you a color grading shortcut that will not only speed up your whole color grading process 10 times for most of your projects, but it will also give you a bunch of flexibility in the way that you grade if you know the ins and outs of it. So secure the cup and let's learn about groups. All right, I'm gonna break this down into three sections for you. What the groups actually do in the color grading process, when you want to use the groups for grading, and then I'll walk you through how to use the groups with some little tips to make things easier for you. First, let's figure out what groups do. Grouping clips together in the color grading process allows you to apply the grading tools and techniques that you have to multiple clips at the same time, which also means that if you decide later in the process that you want to change something in the color grading process to an entire group of clips, you can make that change once rather than having to change it on every single clip or copy and paste the change 100 times. But one of the best parts is that because the way that groups are set up in DaVinci Resolve, you still have the ability to make clip level grading decisions while a clip is inside of a group. This works because the group grading process is split into three parts: group pre-clip, clip, and group post-clip. The group pre-clip nodes will apply any grading that you do to all of the clips in the group very first. So this is probably where you would want to do an input color space transform if that's part of your workflow. For example, I like to put a color space transform from whatever log image I'm using to DaVinci Wide Gamut in this spot. The next section is called clip, and this is actually only happening on the selected clip. So if you need to make specific clip level exposure changes, masks, tracking, anything like that, this is where you want to make that happen. This is super important because this is what allows you to still have that individual clip control when a clip is inside a group. It's also very important to note that the clip grading is happening after the group pre-clip in the order of operations, so anything that you did in that group pre-clip area is now being fed into this grading area. And the third section is group post-clip. This also applies any grading to the entire group, but it applies it after the clip grading. So anything that you do at the clip level will affect the input of whatever you do here. This is typically where you could apply your main look or your creative LUT, as well as where you may want to apply your final output color space transform. So in a nutshell, that's what groups do and what they allow you to do. So next we need to know when you would want to use groups. There are a number of times when using groups can save you time and make your life easier. One of those is simply for color management. By grouping all the clips from any specific camera or color profile, you can put an input color space transform on the group pre-clip, and then you can put an output color space transform on the group post-clip, and then do your whole grade in the clip area if you want. And some of you might be saying, why don't you just use the timeline option? Timeline can be great, but it also applies to titles, fusion comps, graphics, and everything that's on there. So if you do a color space transform on the timeline, it literally applies to everything. Using groups gives you a little bit more control. Another time that you might want to use groups is to group different scenes, sequences, or types of shots together. If you have a project that cuts back and forth between shots from one location to another, one time of day to another, then using groups for each of these different properties can definitely speed things up. Thirdly, you can use groups for different cameras. This kind of goes back to the color management thing, but if you group different cameras, then you can apply whatever camera matching techniques that you have to the entire group, rather than having to individually match clips. And lastly, in combination with what I mentioned before, you can use groups to more easily apply an overall look to a group of clips, rather than having to create that look for every individual clip. So now that you know what groups do and when to use them, let's take a look at how you can actually do it. This is a project I recently shot. If you haven't already seen my complete video breakdown, I'll leave a link in the description where you can check it out. For this video, I made two different color grading groups, one for each camera that we shot on. So let's recreate that. The first thing we need to do to create a clip group is to head to the color page and make sure that our clips are visible. Then we can select clips a number of ways. You can click on a clip and shift click another clip to select all the clips between the two, or you can click on one and command or control click another one to select multiple that are out of order, or you can use different sorting features within DaVinci Resolve to show only the clips that you're looking for. One of my favorites is to flag clips in my media bin and then sort by certain color flag. Then I just highlight all the clips that are showing with command or control A. Once we've got those clips selected that we want to go in our group, we can right click on any of them and choose to add into new group. In this project, I flagged all the DJI Ronin 4D footage as blue and all the Sony FX3 footage as yellow. And if you want a different view of the whole selection process, you can also choose Lightbox and then use the filtering tools on the left-hand side as well. Once you've created a group, you can see all the other clips that are in the group with the clip you have selected with the little green chain link that's next to all of them. If you want to add or remove a clip from a group, you can right click it, go to groups, find the group that you want to choose and hit assign to group, or alternatively remove from group if that's what you're looking to do. In the process, my next step would be to apply my input and output color space transform on the group pre-clip and group post-clip respectively. You can get to the group pre-clip node by clicking on the down arrow beside the word clip or by clicking on the dots for each page. And just like this was a cooking show, I have this already cooked up to show you the delicious results. In this case, the input color space transform is going from either DJI D-Log or Sony S-Log 3 to DaVinci Wide Gamut Intermediate. And then the output color space transform in the last node of the group post clip is going from DaVinci Wide Gamut to Rec 709A. Then in between the two color space transforms, everything could technically be considered part of the overall look. In the group pre-clip, there's a bit of color balance work, a little bit of overall exposure going on, and a reduction of contrast. And then in the group post-clip, there's a lot of color changes, some masking to protect the skin tones, and a film look as well. So the question is, why did I do some of these in the group pre-clip and some of them in the group post-clip? And the honest answer is because that's what I felt called to do at the time. I do try my best to be organized and do things in the quote unquote proper order, but in the end, there's usually a little bit of mess under the hood, but as long as the image looks good, I'm happy. The most important thing to remember about that though is that the nodes are sequential. So anything that you do on that first one affects everything down the line. In the clip level node graph, I would do any specific work needed for that clip that was different from the rest of the group. So usually this just means touching up individual exposure or adding shapes or masks where needed for that clip. But that's not all that you can do with groups quite yet. There's a couple little bonus things if you want to take it to the next level. Let's say you did your groups up and now you've actually decided you didn't want that group workflow. You'd like to keep all the work that you've got, but move to an individual clip workflow now. Right click on the clip that you want to pull out of the group and choose collapse group grades. You can also hit command or control A to highlight all the clips and do this all at once. Resolve will essentially move the group pre-clip, clip, and group post-clip nodes in the same order that they were before, but it'll put them all onto the clip itself. And it will also remove that clip from the group, so now you can deal with it individually without having to start over. The other little bonus about groups is that they work across timelines in the same project. So if you have a secondary edit or a new timeline that you want the same grades you applied in the groups on the first one, you can still right-click the clips on the new timeline and add them into the groups that you created from that other timeline. Then you just have to make clip level changes just like you did before. Now, I'm interested to know if you can think of any other ways where using groups in your color grading would be helpful or speed up your process. If you can think of something, make sure to leave a comment down below to share with everyone. And if you found this video helpful, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button. Make sure to check out this video next. I think you'll really like it. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.